Corey Schneider knocks it away, and the puck taken by Vancouver. Here down the right side is Burrows, tipped away from him. He has to get back outside. He does. Burrows across the line. Puck checked away from him. Now a shot wide to the left side.
Henrik's down, Bob, and he's having a difficult time getting up. He was run over, and it was right at the bench. And now the Canucks go after Brown, and that should be a penalty against Vancouver. It's going to be. So if the Kings can maintain composure here, at least on the penalty box side of things, it must have been Dustin Brown. Now you see Burrows go after Kopitar. It's up to the referee here now to sort it out. Burrows already has one. He already has one. Now he should get an instigator here against Kopitar, because now he's just drawing one of the Kings' best players off the ice. We'll see if the referee sorts it out. Kopitar is strong. Bob, I can't remember. I don't know. Has Andre Kopitar ever been in a scrap? This might be his first one. But we'll see if the referees can figure it out. The hit initially by Brown was not called. There was no call at all. And Henrik looked like he was shaken up. I mean, he looked like he couldn't get back to his feet right in front of the bench. He has it. And just as he turns around, it's not a hit from behind. It's not. Is it late? He gives it up. No, that's not late either. And it's shoulder. It's not forearm. It's not elbow.
And Bieksa came a long distance to get to Brown.
Yeah, so there's going to be a few things for the Canucks to sort things out. And now the fans get a chance to see it. They're going to see it one more time. Sedin thinks it's only Kopitar. And there it is. You see, there's no head contact, but maybe there'll be a whiplash issue. And again, don't get confused a lot of times with the follow-through. The contact was solid and clean. And Brown does his job. Now, of course, I don't blame the Vancouver Canucks, Bob. We've talked about it over the years. Do you go back at Brown there? It's a clean hit. It's right in front of their bench, but it is their best player. And they want to show. They want to send a message. Now they're sorting things out. And it'll be interesting to see how many penalties the Vancouver Canucks pick up here. I think they'll get the initial one. The initial one being chasing down Dustin Brown, and that was called. I saw the referee point. But then Burrows after Kopitar. Now, if you're the referee here, I don't know if you have a chance to sit around and go, okay, what is Burrows doing here? Uh-huh. He's going to go after the best player on the other team and take him off the ice. It's simple up here. You would assume the referees have that type of ability down there to reason things out. Right now on the board, there's a two-minute minor up against Bieksa, Bob. That's the guy you were talking about. So they will sort things out. I assume somehow the Kings will end up with a man advantage. Now, if Henrik Sedin doesn't turn around at the last second here, then it would be a hit from behind. And you can see that he is hurting. And you know what? He is hurting. And there's a lot of times where the Vancouver Canucks have been, you know, criticized for diving those. That's not one of those times. I mean, Henrik was level. He just turned. That made it shoulder to shoulder. And now Brown's talking with the referee. And now he's chatting it up right here with Raymond. So Dustin Brown is a targeted man. Even more of a target right now. 4-on-3 power play.
And the Canucks clear it out to center ice. Kopitar never has had a five-minute major for fighting in the regular season or the playoffs, but he gets one here. But the Kings have a power play. Here's Carter back.